Great. You know what? I'm happy it's Fuji because I thought we were doing Laguna. I don't know. Like, I was looking at the screens like, oh, we're at Laguna again? Oh, man, this is going to be hard.
You must
Like,
be having Laguna withdrawals for Friday night.
yeah, man. No, but because I did Laguna, then I had to do my benchmark for Snail on Sunday, which is in Laguna again, and I remembered because when I did it like a few years ago, I think it was the exact same car and the exact same track. And I remember when I'd done it, I just ran like a few laps. Not okay, now I did this time, let's go. They put me in Division 2 at that time, and I was like, shit, man, I could have put a few more laps and have like half a second or maybe a second better, and I didn't do it. Now, this time around, I just raced like for 10, 15 minutes. I did a good time, and I finally ended up in D1, which I'm happy about.
Nice.
But I don't like that new version of Laguna with the big sausages. It's just like, man, shit, this is wrecking.
Yeah, it's pretty
It was
brutal.
hard with the Porsche, and anyway, you saw me. You were always behind me when I was going out of the freaking
I know.
road. First race, awesome. I was in good position. Harry made a mistake at this spot, and he was so much behind after that that I just had to keep a pace and not take much risks. But second race, I was trying to push to catch people in front.
Yeah,
Not working. Not
Kermit was
working.
giving me hell too, along with you, so.
But man, you made the last mistake of us three, and it paid off. And I remember you signaled me to the left.
I did.
Yeah, but you don't have to do that, I
Nah, you
mean.
know what? Like, if I know, because I'm carrying, like, the weight ballast and all, if I know, like, someone's faster, I'll just. Because I did that with Rove once.
Okay,
I was carrying
but he
extra
told
weight.
you after that, probably, right?
Nah, he was like, dude, I appreciate it. Like,
Okay,
yeah, that was
well, I
awesome.
did because I had good pace, but
Yeah.
I'm in your draft, and maybe you feel like I have more pace and I can tow you around. That I'm cool with
That
because I
was
do that.
exactly the intent. Why put my
Yeah,
flasher?
and you know what? And I was like, okay, he's doing that. Let's tow him and let's go grab some positions, but. Freaking sausage, and then I go off,
Know.
and then okay, so I was like, at a certain point, I was like, shit, man, if he lets me by again, I won't feel good about it because of that.
Actually, it's funny you say that, because Saturday night for the FIAs,
Yeah.
Greasy and I actually out-qualified originals. But Greasy got a better lap with the tow than I did behind him. So he was in front and I was in the middle of the two. So I was like, yeah, let's just work together to try to, stay with the lead pack. And Originals was like fighting us in the beginning. So like
No way.
we lost touch with
Where were you?
we were like 6th, 7th, 8th.
Okay. And you lost contact with like the top five,
Yeah.
which was together?
Yeah, they were all like grouped together.
Holy
There was no, I mean
man,
we
what?
tried.
Yeah.
So there was one point I was like to Greasy, hey, just let Originals by, let's just follow him since he's probably quicker, right? So Greasy's like, yeah, let's do it. We let Originals out in front. He like made like three mistakes in a row and was like slowing us up even more, and we just ditched him.
Yeah. Hey man, I had, I'm gonna tell you the exact same story for me. I qualified, I had Grove behind me. He took my draft and he could have passed me, which would have been all right because I would have taken his draft after that and returned a favor, but we weren't communicating. So in the quali, Grove didn't pass me, but he should have. And then I said, man, you could have passed me and I would have So anyway, we started. I don't know when we started, but where we started, but we were like together, maybe I think I started something like 13, and I was moving through the pack pretty quickly. Maybe I started 9, okay? And we were catching the lead pack. I was me. So there was like 4 people in front. We were 5, 6, and 7 together. And there was an American and a Canadian. I was like, man, I can work with those guys to catch. But the Canadian guy, he was fighty. So I was pushing the American. The American was pushing me, but the Canadian was fighting us both, and we were losing the mid pack. And I was pushing the Canadian because he bullied the American. I'm the only one who got lucky. And then I'm pushing him. Okay, do you understand what I'm trying to do? But they were struggling in the last part of the lap. The first part, we were all equal, but you know, he was overtaking because of the draft, of course. But the last part, the going up, the left, the U-turn, the right turn, they were struggling, and I was clearly faster than them, but the Canadian guy was always fighting. And then at the end, I said, man, thanks to the American and the Canadian, and no thanks to you. And he said, oh, I was trying to work with you. And he said, I was trying to catch the lead pack, but no, you had to fight early. And then he apologized later in the PM. He said, sorry, I was, how did he say that?
I'm a bonehead.
I was like short-sighted, or you know, he didn't see the big picture, yeah. Like something like that. And he said, I clearly thought I was the fastest of us, but clearly I was wrong. And he said that. So I said, you just learned something. So I accept your apology. We are good. But he sent me a friend request right before that. I didn't accept it. I mean, it's gonna take more than that.
Yeah.
You know, we'll have to race a few of them or race together, because you know I have already many friends. So.
Yeah. So I don't know if you watched my stream from that night. So basically, like, we had like 2 laps to go, and I was like to Greasy, all right, how are we going to backstab Originals? And Greasy's just like, you do you, and I'll just follow you. And then literally, like, 2 seconds later, Greasy just slips it up the inside of me. He's like, sorry, I'm taking this line. I was like, you Greasy bastard. But he made his move too soon, because Originals had time to, like, counter.
Oh.
Originals shoved Greasy wide down the hill. So I got a run. I slipped inside Greasy, and then Originals made a mistake. I slipped on the outside going into the final corner, but I had the momentum, and I basically just had more grip, and I went around him on the outside and beat him.
What slot was that?
Top split.
No, I mean, which slot?
That's it was like 6th place. It was like for 6th place. The first slot.
The first slot, the first race, let's say, like 5 races, which one? First, second?
Yeah, the first one.
Okay, because I did the, I think I did the 4th one only. I did like a 216 points out of my 5th position, something like that. And I was like,
oh, nah, wow, the splits went down.
Well, yeah, it's, you know, the top, the victory would have given me 256 points. Oh. So I said, with 216, with a mess like that, I'm saying, okay, I'm going to keep that, but I'm going to focus on other races later on.
So we were in top split. It was like 312 for the win. I got 247. So I was just like, yeah, you know what? Like, as much as I like
this
race,
that's good points.
Yeah, I'm not going to risk losing these points. So bye.
Yeah. What's your DR?
50. Ooh, you know what? I didn't check since the kart race. Let me look.
58, 59, around that, probably, huh?
Maybe 57. Hold on. Where's my...
Oh, well, we have the same DR, you and I.
Hold on. Where did I put my phone?
All right.
Yeah, you know what? I forgot to check after that race.
Fugu, hey, I made my own Fugu livery according to the plan.
All right, so I'm 57-1 now. For DR.
Okay, good.
The funny thing is, at the end of the race, like, I was gonna say, like, hey, like, good race, you know, originals, that was fun, just left. Didn't even say anything. I was like, wow, what a sore loser.
He was probably frustrated.
Yeah, apparently he didn't do it after, because I'm beating him in points, even though it's only the first round.
Those kart races are frustrating.
I love them. I don't know why.
I do enjoy them too, but I mean, it's too freaking dangerous, because people around you, if they touch you, you know, what kind of wheel you have?
The podium from Vandatech.
Okay, I got a G29, so I don't know for you if you can adjust your wheel input or anything, but for my kart, I can. You know, my wheel is straight the whole race. I mean, I just turn a little bit, and it turns like crazy. So
I actually felt the G29 was more comfortable with the carts than the Fanatec, even with me dulling down the settings.
Okay. It's just getting used to it, but yeah. If it kicks out, you're dead. Oh, yeah, I get you, man. Those cards are so responsive.
Wow, light grid tonight, huh? Oh, Rob. Dang, and I'm supposed to be outside the top five to get some weight dropped. I don't even think that's going to happen.
I know. I think... Am I having a weight drop?
Nah, you're same weight.
Okay, good.
I fully expect either you or Gunther to get a weight boost after this.
But I have a weight drop for Porsche next race, though.
Yeah, you're up.
Plus one, I think, or two.
You're plus two, because it's plus two for the win and plus one for podium.
Oh, so I could have been plus three if I would have done a podium. At the second race, right?
Nah, it's out of the event. The entire event.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so since you won it, you're plus two, and I think either me or Donovan are second. So,
oh, okay, so I won overall?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, okay, well, a first place plus a fourth place, I think. Yeah, okay, that's good. Okay, that's a good result. That's an average of 2.5. Because Harry won the second one, but he finished, like, almost last.
Oh, yeah, he was last, the first one.
He was leading. I don't understand what happened.
So he had dirty tires, and he kind of gave me the corner. So I took it. This was, like, the second to last corner we were heading into. He, okay. Like, slowed up, so I took the corner. And then out of nowhere, he just then, like, went for the corner. After he, like, gave it up and just turned into me when I was already on the apex. And the contact just bounced him into the gravel.
So he, at a certain point, he said, okay, I'm done with this shit.
Yeah.
I'm gonna redo myself on the second race. Which yeah. He started, like, second, and he did a perfect race, I don't think. At one time, we caught a few seconds on him. Like, he was, like, 10 seconds ahead.
Yeah,
and
I think he had a
six,
mistake.
But...
Yeah.
Yeah, but that was not a costly mistake, because the first mistake he did was a 5 to 10 second mistake.
Yeah.
It's not the mistake like I did. Exact same spot, but he turned around. He was sideways, stopped on the track.
Me,
I just
he
went wide.
It. Yeah.
I almost, sometimes I kiss the barrier, sometimes I didn't. And you know, I kept on going. He just passed me, but I had like dirty tires and still a little pace.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm all right, muting up.
Sorry
good luck,
for
guys.
All the conversation, but you know we love you guys. Great race, Parrish. Great race. Yeah, I'm sorry about that guy. I had to apologize to Gunther. His mic is muted, but I hope he hears me. Because I broke and I learned something. Oh, man. Immediately. And I've done that turn, you know, a few times in practice. But I just stepped a little too much on it. And when I turned the wheel, I thought I was unlocked. And then, man, whew, it turned right away. Nothing I can do. Well, I had zero on my brake bias. Now I got two to the front because of that.
With all this weight, I have to run at least one to the rear so the fronts won't lock up. I want the weight transfer going up there. Yes. I'm basically like rolling through the corners, trying to carry as much as I can without like any inputs for the most part. I'll try to figure out a way to explain it that's understandable. I'm kind of hard to let the back end come around, and I kind of just use the hill to let it cancel out while kind of maintaining the drift, if you know what I mean. There are some corners you do have to drift it. There's no way around it. Yeah, I'm like basically turning in early, trying to aim for that pylon and just letting the car like drift out. I know, Gunther, you went wild. I was like, ooh, I might have a shot. But then the weight just canceled it out. I was like, oh, that was fun. Or it lasted for a whole 2 seconds. All right, good luck, all.
Tell me when you press start. All right.
Oh my god, race car, that was close. Good race.
Yeah, race.
Yeah, you lost the lead pack too, you jerk. Yeah, that was a good race, honestly.
Yeah, my story of my life. I screwed up the lead, once per race at least. And I had the run on Raul, but I touched his bumper when I tried to pass him at the last moment possible. So I fucked up my run on the last straight, getting to the last lap. Yeah, I know you did, you prick.
Spider Pig, you're not on chat,
it's okay,
are you?
Okay, man, it's well deserved, Raul. You had a great race, man. You deserve that win.
Spider Pig, I don't know if you're on chat, but when you went flying by, all I just saw in my head was, "Look out, he's a Spider Pig." All I had to say is Parrish and freaking Gunther. I was waiting for you guys to like make out your mind who wants to be in front. I was like, come on, I need space to make a run at you guys, and this wall's not helping me. And then next thing I know, a race car's right behind me. I was like, oh great. Please, he probably has half the weight I do. Raul, you want a grand piano? Half price. Today only.
I think when I was leaning at some point, I saw Parrish's car going really close to me at that sharp U-turn. Like, I saw the black in my screen when somebody's near you. Oh, it was the other race. I don't remember, but...
Hi,
I was like, nah! They can miss me by an inch. I've been lucky like that twice or three times already in those races. Like, I saw somebody come, like, no! not really. I was focusing okay. It's just that I misjudged my brake mark on the first turn, so I went too deep, and instead of, you know, spinning like the other race, I just went a little bit forward, and then, well, I'm gonna lose a few positions. Okay, and then I'm in the pack, and I overshoot turn two, like that left-hander before first sector. So I'm losing a few other spots. So yeah, at that point I lost focus, but prior to that I just misjudged my breakpoint. I'm trying my best here, guys.
All right, guys, good luck. I think we're about to get started.
Alright, guys, good luck. Hey, Raul, we are at the back. We got to make a way up the front. Let's do this. Alright, let's do this.
I just wish we worked a little bit better instead of just Dory me, but it's whatever. Dory me on the side, but it's whatever.
Hey Roman, yeah, but early race. Sorry for the punt in the back. I think I got surprised by the pack just, or maybe I misjudged my brake mark. I don't know, but I didn't mean to. That was, yeah, that was something, man. That was fun. Man, I gave it all, man. I gave it all. Whew. My last lap was a 169, and you had a flat 160, man. That was a quick lap. I forgot about the tires, actually.
Yeah.
What's the next track in 2 weeks?
Suzuka.
Oh, this is gonna be, I think Suzuka is gonna be easier than this one. You got like less heavy breakings. Like this, there you got really two big heavy breakings with U-turns that, man, it's make or break. Yeah. When was this one? The last lap? Yeah. Ugh. I get that. Oh, really? Oh. Yes, it was.
Nah, because it just kept hurting my braking zone, so I just kind of wanted to be alone, if you know what I meant.
Oh yeah, great racing. And I'll see you guys in 2 weeks. Here or maybe a buffoon. Alright, see you guys.
See you later.